Goes
Here
upstairs.
Well, we're going to try this one more time. Hopefully we've found the problem. This is an old one, and everyone knows this one. Some glad morning when the strife is over.
That's better.
That's better?
Yeah.
Okay.
Who knows why?
We'll give that a try. We're not sure what went wrong or what went good. Maybe we just shut off a couple of other devices that gave us a stronger signal. Well, good evening, everyone. Sorry for that little interruption, but that's what happens once in a while. Unfortunately, it hasn't happened to us very much before. This is an old song again. It comes back from my roots when I was in the Mennonite church, and I know we can play this one, but I have trouble both playing and singing. So you've got the words, and I want you to sing along and enjoy. It's just simply called "The Church's One Foundation is Jesus Christ Our Lord." Great old hymn.
Came and saw.
That middle verse that we left out there says, mid toil and tribulations and tumult of her war, she waits the consummation of peace forevermore. Till with the vision glorious her longing eyes are blessed, and the great church victorious shall be the church at rest. Great old hymn, we ought to be singing it a lot more because it identifies what Christ designed and what he's building and will never forsake. Well, we want you to share a couple of favorites if you want us to do a couple of them. Maybe we'll just do one verse or a chorus if we know them. Sonia, do we have some that have given any favorites yet?
They're just known, so okay. They might now.
Let me do right now. Let's just move ahead to another page here. I'm going to do one. I hope you can't see the words of the one I'm playing, but this is one you're supposed to guess. Name the tune. So whoever gets it, the first person who gets it, let's go with them.
Okay,
Sonia, the first person who gets this one here, because it's an old one, but not many would people know. Aunt Sharon is that?
Sharon Sutton.
Sharon, Aunt
you
Sharon.
You only got one Aunt Sharon.
Aunt Sharon, you don't know that one. I mean, that came out of our Mennonite background again, but it's published Glad Tidings.
I don't know it.
Yeah, Lorna said she didn't know it. It's called Ozai in Haste, and I think it's 170 in the Melodies of the Glorious Hymns of Praise. Wow, I'm surprised no one got that. Well, we're going to have to do an easier one that maybe
people
would know.
You told me there'd be a whole bunch of people.
Yeah, I said there'd be a lot of people.
Aunt Lynette said Tidings of Joy.
Yes, that's part
See?
Of it. Yes.
Yeah, that's the closest we got.
That's the closest. Oh, my.
Yeah.
Well, he said she would know it.
And Nancy Horner said, me too, Sharon, don't know it.
Oh, my. Well, I'm glad we found one at least that somebody doesn't know. So let's try another favorite that people would know. There is coming a day when no heartache shall come, no more clouds in the sky, no more tears to dim the eye. Thank you. Isn't it the truth? Amen. I want to just throw in a little chorus. We've been watching the most recent conflict that's going on in Israel, between Israel and Palestine, or Palestinians. And it's really sad to see. But as I was sitting watching that last night, I was saying to Lorna, the Bible tells us that in such a time as ye think not, Jesus comes. And a lot of things that we hold dear and are very precious to us now could matter zero 1 minute after the return of the Lord. And so I think it sort of puts it makes a change of things. For those that are Christians, it's the hope fulfilled. But for those that aren't, it's going to be a terrible day. And so we encourage people to accept Christ as their Savior and Lord. But this chorus we've been singing for many, many years, but it's probably more true now than ever before. Find this one. We're going to do that first chorus there, Lorna. Now, if you've got the words, maybe some of you will know it, but let's see what we can do. Thank you. got that one?
Yeah.
Wow.
And then Sharon Sutton got it after.
Okay. Okay. How many are listening in this evening, or how many?
We've got 27 on right at the moment.
There's 27 folk, and do you know any of the names at all?
Yeah, we have Marjorie McDougall, Rick Davies, Linda Como, Jeremy Chapman with Season Phyllis, Timothy Jerram, Rose Heath. Then we've got Betty Humphrey. Who else?
Got a good
Arthur Soller.
Section.
Curtis Handy, Nancy Horner, Lynette Langman, Diane Zimmerman, and Helen Priddle.
Oh, nice. Hello, Helen.
And Laura Hutchin.
Laura, nice to have you from Wichita. Good variety of people from all over the place again there. Sorry for the problems that we had at the very beginning, but that's what they call technical difficulties, and we couldn't do much about that. Who was the first one there? Was it Keith?
Mm-hmm.
Keith's up in Victoria Harbor, I believe. We're going to send out a book to you, Keith, if you'll send me your address. I've got three different booklets here you could take a peek at here, and one is called Armageddon, that one. This one is called Where Were You When the Lights Went Out? And this is one that a lot of preachers have used, and it's called the prosperity message, that this new gospel is a fake. So whichever one of those that you'd like, you just send me by email your address, and we'll send that out.
But just warn people that there should be no gloating on it, because Keith just said, beat you, Sharon, with a laugh.
No gloating.
And Enza also said she's here with Rick and Aunt Judy and Glenn. Aunt Glenn is on.
Okay, nice. Mm-hmm. Good. Nice to see each and every one of you every week. Man, this has been a beautiful week, hasn't it? It just reminds me of, I guess, the urge that we have for summer to come more quickly. So we're going to keep on doing the sing-alongs as long as we can, and people keep enjoying them. So, and if you do us a favor, if you want to just push like on that, that helps us know how many people are there. And if you'd also like to make some comments, as they're doing here now, and also share. We've sent it out to many new people again, so that the more people hear. But we're away this week for a day or two, and some of the folk that we were around down near our cottage, they were saying they hadn't heard about the sings. Other said that they have. So if you just keep sharing the news, people can tune in. I think, like, we started off with about 80 or 90 likes and views last week, and I think it's pushing about 270 now. So sometimes we have 100 or 200 or 300, but people are saying how much they appreciate being able to be built up and encouraged in your faith.
Thank you, Lord, for saving my soul. Salvation, so rich and true free.
memories. Put on the garland of praise for the Spirit. Heaviness, lift up your voice to God. Praise in the Spirit when the heart is failing. Oh, magnify the Lord. Put on the garland of praise for the Spirit. Oh, heaviness, lift up your voice to God.
Got on and just a few minutes ago, so if you ask now, there might be some.
Okay, if somebody does have a favorite you'd like us to sing, just mention it in the comments, and Sonia will tell us, and we just, because we're going to be leaving short and we get a couple more songs, but I also want to pray. I've got two or three prayer requests that have come in, and we just want to pray for a moment, so let's just bow our heads. Father, we're thankful for your saving power and how the Holy Spirit touches hearts everywhere, and something quickens in them, the need to come to know Jesus as their Savior. So I pray, Lord, that many in these last days before you return, I pray that many will come to know Christ. We thank you as well for your healing power. And this evening we do pray, as we reach out to many different ones that have said they have some physical sickness and ailment, we pray for Brother Ralph, that you would continue to touch him, Lord, and heal him completely, and help the doctors and the medical team as they examine for causes and root problems. We pray as well for Brenda this evening, that your hand would be upon her, that you would touch her, Lord, and take away this pain that she's suffering with. We pray as well for Jim. Ask, Lord, that your hand would be upon him in a special way and touch him and heal him by your might and power. We're thankful for what you're doing these days. Pray, Lord, for a great host of people that are suffering with fear and depression and anxiety. Many, Father, that don't think anybody cares. But we know that Jesus cares, and we know that there are other people around who care. And I pray, Lord, right now that in their despair and in their fear, that somehow hope will be planted, that other things will be rooted out of their lives, so that hope and love and the charity and kindness can be put in place, and that they can have a hope for the future, because our hope is in you. That's why you came. So we thank you, Father, for your goodness and your mercy and your love toward us. And we give you praise and thanks in the powerful name of Jesus. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
I have two songs, I think. God Will Take Care of You. Do you know that? That's from Aunt Lynette.
Oh, yeah.
God Will Take Care of You. I don't know if that's a song or if that's a... Then Cece and Phyllis have He's the Lord of Glory, the Great I Am. And I Know Whom I Have Believed. Thank you. yeah, that sounds like that one.
He's the Lord of glory. He is the great I am.
Again, another time. You got that written down, Sonia, so we'll look it up. But we know it really well. It's just lots of we have that music.
And I know whom I have believed.
I'd have to have music. Well, we have the music for that, but maybe Vorna found out it's in three flats. But it's got some of these songs have what they call accidentals in them. So you're going along in a major, and all of a sudden goes into a minor. And that's when you run into the trouble. If you don't hit the minors properly, then they really sound bad. Are you still looking that one up, Lorna?
Yeah.
What's the name of it, the real name?
Come and try this one, Lorna. We know this. We have this as one of our final songs. And if Sonia finds that one.
Oh, I know what. Okay.
I am thine, O Lord. I am thine. And you told my love to thank you.
have asked us if we do any preaching or any speaking at all, and the answer is over, and during COVID, we haven't done a lot. But we're developing a series right now. I'm just calling it 5 Minutes of Time with Pastor John. So if you'd like to be part of that, we're not incorporating that into our sing-alongs, but it'd be separate. It'd probably be about 5 minutes in length. No promises there, but that's where we're starting. And we're already sending out notice of it to those that send us their email. So if you're interested, send me your email. And then about an hour before we do it, I'm not sure what time, but we'll send you a word on it. The first session deals with Ephesians chapter 4 and verse 11 to 16. And that is how God has promised giftings that will bless the church. So that's, you know, 5 with Pastor John, if you're interested at another time. So we'll try this one song, and I think we'll wrap up there unless we have
some. Aunt Sharon said that it's in the key of C, Does Jesus Care?
Yeah.
Whether you want to do that. And Keith Chapman said, good try, thumbs up.
Terrible try, really, Keith. Thanks for the quote. This one is, I know whom I have believed, and it's in the key of 3 flats. Finish on a very positive note. So, Lorna, what's the favorite song you want us to chorus? What happens is our minds go blank when we're looking for favorites.
We
don't have a list. I've got a
mansion.
Leave it there.
night, everyone, and thank you again for listening in. And don't forget to share so that others can enjoy the sing-along as well. May God bless you.